I just got back from the Makerfaire in Prague, and I got a chance to check out what the Voron team is working on. Voron essentially is the last bastion of 3D printers that you build yourself, and with all the highly capable options of ready-to-use printers out there, you might think that there's really no need anymore to spend the time to build one yourself. But printers like these, you just can't buy off the shelf. A big topic for Voron right now is exploring IDEX again, independent dual extruders. It's two tool heads that ride on the same gantry and share their Y-axis movement, but can extrude and move in the X direction independently of each other. So either these have two different filaments loaded, and the printer switches between them for different parts of the print, or they run in sync mode to print the same part twice or mirrored. The center stage Voron platform for this is the new Phoenix, and the one they brought along is actually just a smaller and more portable version of the reference design, which typically uses a quad heat bed for a total 600 by 600 millimeter build area. And because it's fully enclosed, even with little brush seals for the filament inlets, the chamber gets up to 70 degrees Celsius, which honestly you do need if you actually want to use the entire print space with engineering materials. On the flip side, it also means that using 3D printed parts to build the machine itself is asking for trouble. So, as a first for Voron, the Phoenix now relies quite a lot on the structural parts being machined from aluminum, which also makes the motion system incredibly rigid. Like most Vorons these days, everything is run by the Clipper firmware, and because that's all an open ecosystem, adapting it for now controlling two independent toolheads was possible at all. But that adaption is not quite finished yet, and things like swapping filaments in a toolhead that is currently not printing and parked and idle still need to be implemented. Also, you might think that a DIY solution this complex would be rather crude, but their IDEX machines actually have a tension-controlled pre-feeder extruder and half a dozen sensors in each filament path, so the machine knows more about what's going on with its filament than most printers you can buy. Oh, did I mention they're also just running the Tridex with a box turtle filament multiplexer into one of the toolheads as well? Because of course you can do that, and if you can do it, then somebody will do it. Though, the Voron printers always have a sort of reference version that they design as a highly capable, functional platform, and that's the one the team would actually recommend building first for the smoothest possible learning curve before you start venturing into the world of upgrades and mods. Voron has always been very good with documentation, and simplifying the builds and the softer tuning that has to happen once the machine is physically done is one of their bigger priorities going forward. But of course, these machines are infinitely moddable as long as you're willing to put the effort in. Voron doesn't actually sell printers. The core team and the over 50,000 user strong community just enjoy developing them. So if you want to build one, you can either self-source the parts individually or, now of course, buying a full kit from one of the various sellers is easier than ever.